What is going on, everyone? It is Mike, and welcome back to Tech 24/7 TV. So Apple just released the newest version of its operating system, which is iOS 13. Works on the iPhone, works on the iPad. And in today's video, I'm gonna go through and share my favorite tips with you. And if you're looking for the best tips for your iPad, that content's dropping very soon. So make sure you are subscribed with notifications to be alerted when that content does come out. First up, it's dark mode. Now this year, Apple finally gave what people have been asking for since I think it was enabled in tvOS about 3 or 4 years ago. This is system-wide dark mode. Now let's start with a few tips on dark mode. Now you can enable and configure this preference by navigating, to the settings app, then go down to display and then to brightness. And the first thing you're gonna be presented with is a radio button for either a light or dark appearance. So you can have the appearance automatically change based on the time of day by either sunset or sunup, or based on an actual time of day. Now me personally, I like to have it at sunrise to sunset and not worry about it, kind of a set it and forget it type of person. New in iOS 13 this year is the ability to darken your wallpaper and background if you have dark mode enabled. Now this is gonna help you if you ever find yourself looking at your phone either late at night, maybe you're in bed. You can enable dark mode in the brightness slider found in Control Center, but you can also save yourself a step and put it directly in the Control Center. Now let's navigate back to settings, then head down to Control Center. Let's click customize, and there you see all the options which are sorted alphabetically. Let's tap on the green plus button next to dark mode and leave it where iOS placed it. Now if we open up Control Center, which is found either in the top right, if you have an iPhone 10 or later, or from the bottom up, there's the dark mode toggle right at the bottom row, allowing you to enable or disable with just one press. And listen, it's better than two presses, and who doesn't like to save time? Now the last one here for dark mode is gonna be a little advanced, but it's simple once you see me do it. Now if you don't know what shortcuts is, you can think of this as being analogous to programming a computer without needing to know how to program it. Let's open up shortcuts. Now you may or may not already have shortcuts in there, but let's click on the add shortcut. And then there in that dialog box, we're gonna type in appearance. Now that variable is already pre-filled here with dark, but if you tap on it with your finger, you can either choose light or ask each time. Let's leave it how it is. Go ahead and name it. You can name it dark mode or be clever if you want. I'm gonna name mine darkest of nights and I'm gonna tap save. Now I can activate Siri and say darkest of nights and she will enable dark mode. And conversely, I can create one for, light appearance and call that let there be light, and Siri will do just the opposite. All right, next let's see what's new in messages. First, it's gonna be the ability to add a profile pic that is automatically exchanged with people that you message with. Let's open up messages, and in the top right-hand corner, we're gonna click on the horizontal ellipsis. We're gonna select edit name and profile. Now for me, my first name was already filled out. For you, it may or may not be, but go ahead and fill that out. Put your first name, last name, your nickname. Now I'm gonna go ahead and choose edit right underneath the photo. Now for me, I have pre-existing photos here that Siri knows that it is me. I'm gonna go ahead and choose the camera button underneath and I can take a photo of myself. Or I can go ahead and click the plus button to create a new animoji. Now I'm gonna select using an existing animoji. I'm gonna go ahead and use this in messages and then I'm gonna click done. Now you have the option to use this picture everywhere, including your Apple Store profile, in addition to your photo on your Mac, your iPad, and your Apple TV. Now I'm going to use this automatically share it with contacts, meaning the next time I send a message to someone, whether it's my mom, my dad, it doesn't really matter, as long as you're my contact list, they'll get a pop-up on their side saying that the name and or profile pic for the person that they're messaging with has changed and given the option to save it. Also new in messages this year is gonna be the additional styling that you can do to your individual Memoji character. They have new hairstyles, new headwear, makeup, piercings. So you can do a lot of customization, and even better, you can add a Memoji or an Animoji for someone in your contact list by going into contacts, looking at their picture, clicking edit, and then adding the Animoji character. Number three is gonna be Haptic Touch, and this is probably my favorite update for iOS 13 because it brings functionality that was previously limited to more expensive devices to everyone that can run iOS 13, including iPads. Haptic Touch allows you to short press on almost anything within iOS 13 and iPadOS to get contextual menus. Now, for example, you can short press on the messages icon to see different contextual menus, say you wanna send someone a message. Now, this list is dynamic and it should change based on time of day and location. But also the rabbit hole is gonna go a little bit deeper here. Now I can press on the contact photo to see options in terms of how I wanna contact them, in addition to being able to short press on the message thread to get a preview of the messages and other pre-canned responses. Now what is really nice here is that previewing the message doesn't actually mark the message as read if you have read receipts on. And if you do have read receipts on, you can actually choose the option there to mark it as read. Now, if you remember, there was something called jiggly mode. If you wanted to go ahead and move an app around your phone, you had to long press on that app for like 3 or 4 seconds, and then all the icons would go ahead and enter jiggly mode. That's what I like to call it. It's a very technical term, jiggly mode. But this is going to be real simple. Now, you can long press on any app for about 3 seconds, and that will put all the apps into jiggly mode. Or if you short press on any app from the home screen, the very first option is going to be rearrange apps, which is the same exact thing. Again, this is going to work in a number of different places, including the iPad. So really all it is just start experimenting and short pressing it anywhere that you can. Now, I don't know about you, but I used to get around 20 to 30 robocalls per day until this feature came out, and it has been a savior to my sanity since. Now, the feature is going to be called Silence Unknown Callers, and it's found in Settings, then under iPhone. Now, this does exactly what it says it's going to do. It's going to silence any phone number that's not stored in your contact list or that Siri is not aware of by sending that caller directly to voicemail. Now, this is one thing I'd give caution here. While this is a great feature, if you're someone who happens to either, you know, join a lot of conference calls for work, or if you dial into bridges often, if that bridge happens to call you instead of you calling into it, like WebEx does, I know Skype does this, if you don't have that phone number stored in your phone book from the bridge, right, those calls will go directly to voicemail. So that was something I had to tweak the first few times I actually had this going on. So there are many new features inside iOS 13 that are about privacy and security, but I'm going to focus on two of them. The first one's going to be location services. So new this year is that you can go ahead and set up new controls for location access. So any number of apps can ask for your location. And what you can do new this year is that you can go ahead and grant it one-time access. To check your privacy controls, you're going to go ahead and settings. You're going to go to privacy, location services, and then you're going to get a listing of every app that's installed on your iPhone and whether or not they're getting location data. Additionally, you can go ahead and limit the ability for an app to go ahead and gain access to Bluetooth data that it could gain by scanning your local environment. And then for Bluetooth settings, you're going to go in the same menu. It's going to be listed right below that, and you'll get a listing of apps that ask for your Bluetooth data. Our sixth and final tip is going to be Safari. Safari is more robust than ever, and it's giving users fine-grained control over privacy. So go ahead and tap on settings and go down to Safari, which is the fifth section from the top. And here in Safari, we're going to look for a couple things. So the first thing is downloads. So now in Safari, there is desktop class browsing, meaning now that you can go ahead and use your phone to go ahead and navigate to websites, and you'll get served the desktop version of that website. No more mobile versions. And additionally, what you could do is you can download files to your phone here. Your downloads folder is probably set to iCloud Drive. And what that means is if you have iCloud Drive enabled, if you download whether it's a song or a picture, it's going to put that piece of content or that file into a synced folder between all of your devices. Now you can choose to override that by choosing a different folder. Maybe it's going to be on your phone, or you can go ahead and put it into an external drive. Now the next thing is going to be in the next section down, which is going to be tabs. And now in iOS 13, you have the ability for automatically close Safari tabs after a given period of time. And that's configurable either 1 day, 1 week, or 1 month. Now, the last two tips are going to be for those of you who have an Apple Watch and you've upgraded to watchOS 6. First, you have the ability to delete apps that are core to watchOS, like Breathe, Activity, Alarm, Stopwatch, freeing up unnecessary space. Because if you have an older Apple Watch, you only have 16 gigs of internal storage, and every gig counts. And if you do accidentally delete something that you shouldn't have, you can always re-download that from the App Store. But now on watchOS 6, you have the App Store on your wrist. Second, I'd go ahead and turn on ambient noise alerts, and I think you'll be really surprised how often you find yourself in an environment that is loud enough to damage your hearing. Just something to kind of be aware of. All right, that about wraps it up for me. Those are my 6 tips to get you started on iOS 13 and watchOS. Why don't you go ahead and leave any questions that you have about either iOS 13 or watchOS 6 in the comments below. And again, if you're looking for the 6 tips to get you started on iPadOS, I'll go ahead and link that above. It will be available after iPadOS launches on September 30th. I am Mike, and this is Tech 24/7 TV. Hit like, hit subscribe, and I will talk to you in the next one.